Hi, welcome to One People, One World. My name is Rabbi Yakov Cohen. I'm here with Avi Weinberg. Shalom, Avi, how are you? Tell us all about it. He's going to enlighten us on how to be happy and to be successful and happiness, which we all yearn for, desire, happiness, which is the key for everything. Please, Avi, tell us about your work for the past 30 years. He's been involved in research and so on, in happiness.
Okay, shalom everybody.
Yeah.
It's truly my honor to be able to do this. And to cut to the chase, like they say, I've been working on a project for over 30 years. And the project is...
In New York or in... Or
yeah, I come originally from Lawrence, New York.
Lawrence, okay. Okay. Yeah.
Right? And my project is to show people that... show people that our happiness of life is our most precious possession. Mm-hmm. And it is our most powerful and greatest tool for taking full advantage of life's myriads of opportunities presented to us throughout our lifetime.
Okay, so how do we achieve happiness? What's the secret of happiness? So, everyone desires happiness. Actually, it says that Ivdu es Hashem b'simcha, that you shall serve God with joy, and unlike other religions, which proselytize out of fear and so on, Judaism teaches us that joy, happiness, could elevate a person, bring a person to much higher, greater, and that much more pleasurable. And God wants us, He created a world, a garden, for us to have a garden is a place of pleasure. So we have to enjoy it, not just feel like, I have to put on tefillin, I have to do this. So how do we do that? Go ahead.
Okay, so one of my key points is to bring out that Yiddishkeit,
Judaism,
that Judaism is not a religion. And what it is, and it's not a way of life. It's actually the way of life. What do I mean by that? What I mean by that is, let's say I invite a guest to my house for the weekend.
Right.
And I provide for this guest room and board, all the amenities, food, comfort, anything and everything that a guest could ever want.
Right.
Right? And now the guest leaves. And the guest doesn't say a word. No thank you, no recognition, no appreciation. So I say to the guy, to the girl, whatever, I don't mean
To be rude,
but like, I'm just curious, like, you know, why don't you say thank you?
Or did you at least, if you don't say thank you, tell you at least to say, you know, complain and say, I had the worst weekend, the worst Shabbos. In other words,
Either
positive or negative.
Right. Now,
it's some reaction.
Some reaction. Now, it's not like I need it, but let's say for my wife, let's say my children, got involved. I'm just curious, like, why aren't you expressing yourself in any which way? So the person says, who are you? I mean, you provide for me, says who? Who are you? Like, I don't know you. I mean, you're not the one that provided me. It was just provided. I mean, what do you have to do with the equation here? That's it.
So, in other words, they don't have recognition that the fact that you just...
They don't have recognition of where it's coming from. They don't have recognition of how good it is. They don't have recognition of why it's being given to them. And they don't have recognition of what they can do with it.
So it really boils down to realizing that every good thing, or every bad thing for that matter, even the trials and tribulations that we go through in life, and not always, as they say, is life a bowl of cherries, but everything comes from Hashem, from God. And even sometimes the bitter medicine is also a medicine, a good medicine. It's like sometimes a father will slap a child if he's ran across the street in front of cars. to warn him out of love, even though the smack hurts, but that smack will remind him and protect his life from running across, and God forbid. So God also sometimes, but everything comes. Ultimately, we want, as we say, B'tov Hanira Vanigla. The Rebbe always said, we should see blessings in the reality, in the good. Not in the concealed good, but in the real good, as we understand it. So go ahead. So you,
it's okay, so the thing is, I'm going to focus completely positive, without getting involved in any negative, comparatively speaking, etc., etc. Okay, so the point is like this. Number one, there's, we as a nation are referred to as Jews. Okay? Now, if we analyze the word Jew, it may not have any source whatsoever. That means, where did they come up with the word Jew? Now, people will say the word Jew comes from Judea, Samaria.
It's brought down in the Gemara through Yehudi. Is not a biblical term. It's not a scriptural term. But it says Shakol Kafir Bavayizari. Yehudi means the other side. It's called anyone who announces, denounces idolatry or idol worship is called Yehudi.
Okay. So the point being is, even, and there's another source for the word Jew as from Judah. Okay. Now, there's a word that, let's say, Lashon HaKodesh, in the Hebrew language, etc., etc., which is referred to as Yehudi. Okay? Now, let's say we spell it in English. Y-E-H-U-D-I. Okay? What does Yehudi mean? Yehudi means thank you. That's what it means. So we say Avram, Abraham, was the first Yehudi. Why was he the first Yehudi? Because he brought attention that every single thing that a person has is a gift from Hashem,
from God.
Right? And the reason why we get this gift, number one, it has a source. So we recognize the source of it. We recognize how good it is. We recognize why it's being given to us. And we recognize that there's something else that could be done with it other than appreciate it and be happy ourselves. It's basically, Hashem wants us to be happy. Or shall I say, to access our happiness. I'll explain what I mean by that. To access our happiness. And the ultimate, the next level, let's say, is to share it with another person. And the ultimate ideal is sharing it with another person together with Hashem.
Okay.
Okay?
So how do we get this happiness? How do we, you know, we can look at the glass half full or half empty.
Okay.
How do we look at the positive and see life as good?
Right. Okay, so now, the thing is, I say, positive, well, that means I'm referring to like this. Positive is reality, negative is imagination. Okay, now, whoa. That's very dangerous. Let me back up for a second.
Okay.
This is not about not validating people's emotions and feelings. Okay. It means people go through terrible things, past, present, future, and to tell a person, listen, be happy. Share your happiness with somebody else. Appreciation, blah, blah, blah. I mean, come on, who are you? Were you like a mean person? You don't care about other people's feelings? This is not about that at all. This is about validating everybody. Validating their feelings, their emotions,
what about
their trials and tribulations.
Someone who just went through the worst trauma that's imaginable.
Right.
Losing a child.
Right.
You know, terrible things.
Terrible accidents. Cancer.
Yeah. A lot of...
Right.
What do you say to them?
Okay. So the thing is like this. The question is, what is reality? Is reality made up by people? Or is there another reality? That's a reality that can't be touched. Now, the question being is, this reality, is it a good reality or is it a bad reality? That means if that was the choice. Of course, we can go somewhere in the middle all the time. But bottom line, if we had to answer the question, is reality good or is reality bad? Next question. Am I, together with everybody else, are we innately in our DNA happy people? Or perhaps we're not happy people. We are miserable people. What's the difference? So let's take the last thing we just spoke about. What's the difference whether I'm a happy person or whether I'm a miserable person, a sad person? Ready? Difference could be, okay, and remember this is all my opinion.
Right?
Okay. The difference could be as follows. If I am a happy person, so now when I'm not happy, and somebody says, hey, Avi, you don't look so well today. I say, you're right. I'm not feeling myself. I'm not myself today. Fine, good, no problem. But if I'm a miserable person, that means if this is who I really am, now I'm in trouble. Why? Because when I'm happy, it's baloney. It's like fluff and utter. It's like, it's an experience, it's once in a lifetime. And not only that, I don't even know how to get that. It's like, I can't figure it out. Okay. It's kind of like, whoa, so all of a sudden I'm happy.
Okay, so that's the whether a person is innately happy or miserable.
Right.
First question.
Okay, now, the first question of, what was the first question again? Remind me.
The question was whether you, how do you become happy?
Oh, okay, so now, the thing is like this. There are a few proofs that happiness of life exists, that the world is a good place. Let's think about these three proofs, okay? One is that we bring children into the world. Now, if life was terrible, why would I have the audacity, why would I have the chutzpah, why would I be such a degenerate to bring children into a world that's terrible? That's one thing. Another thing, very interestingly, bad sticks out. I mean, that's usually, bad really has an effect. That could mean that the world is a good place. That means primarily the world is a good place in its whole. So when something bad happens, it sticks out. However, if the world was a bad place, so then bad would just blend right in. And good would stick out. Okay? Perhaps there's another proof. If we take a look at little children, infants, crawlers, etc., they're happy, they're giggling, they laugh, they wake up happy, they take a toothpick, and they pick up the toothpick like it's a building, and they take a piece of dirt, and it's like a car. They're very happy. Unless, of course,
And also, one of the things you learn from children is they could fall and cry, and had the worst day, and 2 seconds later, they snap out of it.
Right.
And they're back on their feet, and they could fight with someone, and 2 seconds later, they're best friends.
Right. Okay. So now, the thing is, let's take an example of a guest. Okay, so that means, if I receive something from somebody, and so I'm supposed to recognize that there's a source from it, and I say thank you, etc., etc. Okay?
About a guest, about the first guest, about when you said that someone, you hosted someone and didn't acknowledge one way or the other way.
Okay.
So you have to accept. Let me just give you one little throw in one nutshell, which is a big nutshell actually.
Okay.
But the Alter Rebbe, Rabbi Shnei Zalman Ladi, explains in Tanya, one of the ways to achieve happiness, even when something bad happens in the world, there are unfortunate cases of bad or evil, and so on, is to make a blessing on bad, just as you make a blessing on good. To see the bad as ultimately good. Like the goal is the exile that we're now, which seemingly seems like an endless, most difficult goal is that we've endured and so on. But ultimately, it's to bring out the inner resources of a Jew in the world, and to bring out the godliness and the goodness that exists in everything. So ultimately, even the challenges, we have to make a blessing on. That's why we say, when someone passes away, Baruch Dayan Emes.
Right.
Because even though for the person who went through this tragic loss, yet for God, it's the bigger picture. It's beyond us.
Okay. Good.
So. So you're saying it's all about thanking God. It blends into.
First of all, I just want to say that I'm not that careful. I want to come across as a regular person.
You are.
I'm not a person. You know, if I lost my train of thought, it's fine. I'm a regular person.
Right, right.
I'm not a rabbi. I'm not a mentor.
Right.
I'm just a regular person that has things like anybody else has. I'm not special.
Every person is special.
I mean, I'm special.
Every person is special.
We're all special. But what I mean to say is...
Right, go ahead.
I want to come across as who I am.
This show is really about reaching out.
I'm not flawless.
Right. This show is about reaching out to people in the wider world. It's the ears in Manhattan every Thursday night. And basically, it's to provide a normal people with a word... of a good word to say. And obviously by you coming on to this show and expressing these ideas of being happy and being thankful and so on, that in itself is a plus.
Okay, good.
I want to thank you again.
My pleasure.
You know, and
this is my pleasure.
You've made not me happy, you've made, hopefully, I know there's thousands of viewers out there in TV land.
Like I said in the beginning, it's an honor for me.
Yeah.
This is something that I dreamed of, to be able to come out and share my thoughts, my insights on happiness.
Okay, so
before I lost my train of thought, what I meant to say is like this. If there is a source for everything that we have,
right.
And let's take the idea that there is Hashem, there is a God, and who created this world, why did he create the world? To give to us. And he's giving to us a great world, a good world.
Right.
Now, he doesn't expect the impossible from us, because otherwise it's ridiculous. So now, what happens to all the trials and tribulations and the challenges and etc., and the problems and the pain? What did God give us to be able to deal with this stuff? If we don't have anything to deal with this, then
he doesn't.
How can it be a good world?
No, he doesn't. He doesn't give you a mountain you can't climb.
Right. Okay.
So challenges. You have the answer.
Right. So, I'm coming from an angle like this, that happiness of life, my happiness, sharing my happiness, realizing where the happiness comes from, is the cure all for anything and everything. It may not be something that I'm able to reach right now, but this could be the goal. And why would I try to reach this goal? Because it could be the cure-all, and not only the cure-all, but the way to get on top of the game and really live life to the fullest. To enjoy it, and to look forward to it. And every day when we get up, and every day when we go to sleep, we look forward to the next day. When we get up, we're charged, and we're happy to be alive, and we look happy. Okay, so now, if our happiness of life is something that we have to achieve, how does one become happy? Where do I get happiness from? What do I have to do to be happy? Even though happiness would be our most precious possession, it's our greatest gift, etc. So, okay, not so bad. We have to do something to get it. But I'm coming up with a different idea, and it may not be only my idea, that we all have happiness of life inside of us. Each one of us was given happiness of life. Okay? So now, it's not what do I have to do to be happy, it's not how do I achieve it, are there steps, etc. No. It's just accessing our happiness of life. So, again, it's not something I have to do, because people don't like to have to do anything. It's something I want to do. It's something that's necessary.
And it's something that's within you.
It's something that's
within me.
It's not even within my reach. It's not me.
It's you. It's not like a something which comes from externally.
Exactly.
It's from within.
It's from within.
Within a person.
And not only that, it is me.
Right.
It is you. Primarily me. And we can all think it's not primarily us.
It's
primarily us, is our problems, our challenges, our misery, our pain, our suffering. That could be us. But hold on, maybe it's not.
It's not, because God...
I'm saying, yeah. You know what I mean? We're looking at it from the ideal situation, and you know how to maneuver and how to live. I mean, sometimes we feel like we can't live. Sometimes we feel it's impossible. We can't go on. We're just surviving. We're just existing. So now, Abraham, not only did he say that there's a source for everything, mm-hmm. and it's given, I mean, how great it is, and why is it being given, and what can we do with it? He came up with a new idea. Mm-hmm. His idea was that God, as great as God is, he created the universe, etc., the galaxies, the stars, whatever. He's involved in every little detail, the minutest detail of my life, God is involved. And not only is he involved, he, she, whatever it is, this being, not only are they involved, right, but they have this signature on every little detail. You know what the signature is? Hi, I'm God, I love you. And this is why I give you, this is why I gave you, this is why I give you, this is why I will give you these things. It's because I love you.
Right.
Okay? Now, people
and
said...
Again, and the person has to understand that not always do you have sweet life, easy path.
Oh, so in a way,
sometimes right. there are bumps in the road, and right. sometimes there are challenges.
Right.
And the challenge only there for you to overcome.
Right, okay.
And so, to become stronger.
Right, but now that you mention this...
In other words, people think, oh, if I have this challenge, well, God doesn't love me, or God's not there, or I'm not... The answer is no. Sometimes the challenge is everything, if you realize that God is like you said, orchestrating every aspect of your life, then even the challenges are part of God.
Okay, very good. So now, the thing is like this. The question, there's one question that comes about. How much do I create my own destiny? And how much is it God? That means, there's a concept. Watch this. This is like right. amazing, and it's maybe beyond, you know, right now. That bad doesn't come from God. Now, there could be two explanations to that.
Evil,
no, evil doesn't, yeah. that means bad things don't come from God.
Okay? You know, with evil
right.
is actually the absence of light. It's a non-entity. Meaning, it doesn't. It's only when you don't have light do you have evil,
okay,
or darkness.
Okay.
So it's a non-entity.
It's funny because you know, what is it? In other words,
it's a non-entity. Meaning that that's why you don't have to be strong. They say the Jewish people are only a fraction of a percent of the world's population, and yet we're going to provide the Torah with a message of peace and harmony and so on. The answer is it's not about quantity. One match could light up a whole football stadium. It's one light of Torah, one switch that creates that light, creates that beam.
It's funny because, in a sense, one of the proofs that there's no darkness is because they're nocturnal animals that are able to see in the dark like we see in the daytime. So, like, what's up with that? I mean, it's, you know what I'm saying? Like, what's going on?
A night owl.
I mean, is it dark or is it night? I mean, like, right. what's happening here? Okay. Now, one more thing that's very important, which I should have said in the beginning.
Yeah.
I really would appreciate if people would try to see the good in me. Okay. You know, in the rabbi.
I see.
I think it's important to see the good because if a person is looking for the bad, they can find it.
Everything.
In
every
cinch,
second.
You know?
Yeah.
So
you always have to look at the right eye.
Right, and we also want everybody to give us the benefit of the doubt
yeah, right.
that we're making an effort
to try to
and right, our effort is we're trying to show people how happy we are and to share it and how to solve everything through happiness. And it's so interesting. When do we need our happiness of life most? When things are going well or when things don't go well? When is it more important to be happy? When things are going well and when things are not going well? Hello. It's great when it's going well.
Right.
But we need it most. We see that we need it most when things are not going well.
Right.
Because we all know that when things don't go well, or they don't go the way we see it, bam, we give away our happiness of life in 5 seconds flat. It's like a guy comes and puts a gun to our head and says, I want your cash. He needs the cash. I say, whoa, 1 second. You want it? You're holding me up? Come with me to my house. And in my house, I have a safe. And in the safe, there's an heirloom. It's worth $100,000. And he gives it to the thief. The thief thinks that he's crazy. I mean, like, what's your problem, man? You're giving me away your most valuable possession. I mean, I just held you up. I need cash for the next hit. What are you doing? So watch. As soon as something goes wrong, not our way, we go to the safe and we take out our most precious possession, the most precious possession, we give it away. I mean, hello. Like, what are we doing? Just the opposite. When something doesn't go our way, that's when we should say, hey, happiness of life, let's go. The first thing is the playing field is happiness of life. That's my playing field.
When the tough gets going, exactly.
Right. Or the tough goes shopping. You know what I'm saying?
And when happiness kicks in.
Or the tough get tougher.
Or you become happy.
Okay, so now, when we get tougher, what is that? Is it us? Can we be tougher?
It means resources, getting that happiness.
Let's access it and let's not
fall apart and realize that everything comes from Hashem, from God.
Right, okay, so now, getting back a little. When something bad happens, or it doesn't seem our way, it's very possible that there's so much destiny that God allows us to create that maybe I created my own destiny. For example, there was once a family that, I mean, God forbid it should ever happen to anybody, but the woman lit Shabbos candles, okay? And they left a child, and a child, right, one of the children got burned.
Yeah.
Dead, okay? They panicked, they freaked out, why did it happen, what's going on, what did I do, oh, right? And they went to one of the biggest rabbis in the generation. And they said, Rabbi, maybe can you give us an idea, like, what's going on? Like, why are we so terrible? Like, what was the matter with the child? He said, 1 second. There's one thing we learned from this, more than anything else, perhaps, is that we cannot allow a child in a room with candles burning alone.
Right.
Okay? So it may not be that God did this to us, he striked us, he did this and that. God says, you know what?
We also can't understand God's ways.
We cannot.
We can't question. Because if you can't question Hashem's, because you know something like that is a terrible, terrible situation.
Right.
So you can't, ultimately, they say there's a line which says, relax, God's in control.
Right.
So if you relax and say,
take your hand over
to him. Take your hand and realize that everything comes from God, even challenges. Let's talk a little bit about your uncle.
Right.
You come
from I'm fortunate to
illustrious family,
right,
of rabbis.
To have Rabbi Noah Weinberg is my uncle, my father's brother.
Your father's brother, Rabbi Noah Weinberg. And I understand, I'm working with the Institute of Noahide Code, which we're promoting the Universal Noahide Code, both on this TV show as well as in the United Nations.
Right.
And I understand your uncle, your late uncle, was also very much involved in promoting the Sheva Mitzvahs, the seven universal Noahide Code. Let's talk about Rabbi Weinberg.
I mean, I was fortunate to spend some time with him.
Yeah.
And
he was born in America.
I believe he was born in America in the Lower East Side.
Right.
Okay. Rabbi Noach had a breath of life. He saw the world as the world needs help.
Right.
Okay? So that means we're addressing the entire world. This is not about a small sect of people that are going to hold themselves up in a little place.
He saw the bigger picture.
He
was one of the pioneers that promoted the Kiruv movement.
The Kiruv movement, right.
The bringing Jews closer to Judaism, to their Jewish roots.
Obviously. But watch.
He was actually involved in I think, which organization was he involved in?
Aish HaTorah.
Aish HaTorah, that's right. Aish.
So, but it's so interesting that Rabbi Noah, Rabbi Weinberg, he once said, Avi, you know what? God wants to improve. Wants us to improve. Why? Because this way we can get more from him.
Yeah.
That means if I have a cup, there's only a certain amount of soda that will fit in the cup. Right. If I have a bigger cup, there'll be more soda.
If you empty, if you empty the Kli Dekon Mamzik.
Right.
As if you empty, if you're full of yourself, right. You can't. There's no room for God.
The bigger our receptacle,
and the more we can receive.
Right. And the way it works opposite
of Ruchnis and Gashmis, they're two opposites.
Well.
So no, in a way,
right.
Like it says, someone who's satisfied with himself, Begashmis, is a good thing.
Physically.
In other words, if you have enough money in the bank, you're happy. It's a good thing. Not always to want more. If you're happy with what you have in Ruchnis and spirituality, it's not a good thing. Also, when it comes to filling up a vessel, the bigger the vessel, the more you can receive in the physical.
Right.
In spirituality, the less you are of a vessel, the more you can receive. In other words, the less of a yesh, the less of a vessel you are, the more you're open to receiving Hashem's divine energy and light and Torah and mitzvahs.
Right. However,
so Rabbi Noah Weinberg, let's talk about this.
Right, okay, so Rabbi Noah says that Hashem wants us to improve so that we can enlarge our vessel of receiving from Hashem.
Mm-hmm. Very nice.
Okay, so getting back to the bad things that happen, the challenges, etc. So number one, a lot of it can be how we're creating our destiny and we're creating bad stuff.
And also, to see, look beyond, like your uncle, look beyond the bigger picture.
Right.
Don't look at everything that happens to you as you. Just relax, trust in Hashem. He's running the show. And say, you know, listen, this is a bump. This is a big hit, big bump in the road. But like you say, you're gonna go into that safe and reach for the happiness. Because ultimately, the ultimate path is Ivdios Hashem B'Simcha, serve God with joy. I think we're gonna have to wrap it up. So,
okay.
But you know, I think that's the two nutshells we could take out of our little talk over here. Is number one, don't throw away the precious heirloom, which is happiness.
It's our most precious possession, and this is our tool.
And number two is realize that everything comes from Hashem,
but from a loving Hashem.
A loving Hashem,
right?
And even like I say,
let's give Hashem the benefit.
No, you're right. You know, like I say, sometimes when a parent will slap a child in order not to cross the road or not to touch the oven, even though that hurts.
It looks bad,
but ultimately it's to save the child. And also the goal is, the exile win, is only to give birth to Mashiach.
Right.
To redemption.
Right.
The trials and tribulations,
right.
And we Jews have witnessed for thousands of years, it's ultimately for me to serve you in the Beis HaMikdash as a Kohen. Okay. Ultimately, for everyone to be in the Beis HaMikdash and to see God and to know God and to appreciate God and the challenges and so on will cease to exist. But ultimately, that's what it's all about. It's bringing out the ultimate, which is to bring out, like Rabbi Noach said, to reach you, to get into a better state.
To become improved.
So in other words, you go to one trial, to be able to go to the next level. Now you can go to level B.
Okay, I mean, I just want you to know, it gets a lot better.
It gets a lot better.
Oh, it gets a lot better.
If someone has any questions, could they email you?
Absolutely.
What's the email? Can you leave
Happiness up? By Avi W at gmail.com.
That's happiness?
Happiness, HAPPINESS.
Right.
By BY Avi, AVI. W@gmail.com and my phone number.
You don't have to give me a phone number.
Oh, okay, fine.
Because I don't know who. Oh, okay. You may get a lot of calls at night. You know.
Okay.
You know?
Okay.
But the happiness, be happy, and create happiness at following.
Right. Before we end.
Yeah.
Recognizing the source.
The source is
Rabbi Cohen.
No, it's
right. Hashem wants us to be human.
Right, right.
Love your neighbor as yourself.
Right, right.
I am God. Not I am God. Love your neighbor as yourself. Okay. So Hashem wants us to appreciate each other, right. Not only appreciate Him.
I love you.
So really, there are no words. I really mean it from the bottom of my heart. There's no words to say thank you.
And thank you for.